Hey, welcome back. I'm very happy to be here today with Sally Goldman. Sally's a professor at Washington University, is also a researcher at Google. We'd like to talk mostly about the process of choosing the right algorithm and data structure and how your programs are so much tied to that choice.
The big picture, I think, in terms of what we focused on the book is if I'm looking at a data structure for a problem, there's broad classes of data structures. Some data structures are very good just searching something with a unique ID. Other things may be good at finding, like I want to find if the word CAT is that substring is part of a word. And so there's this broad class of a data structure. So really, the encapsulations is important is to understand these abstract data types or ADTs and understand which one of those fits your problem, because that's the fundamental decision. And there's less of them, so it's easier. So first of all, invariant is something typically about your data that holds all the time. So if I have something called a search tree, I may say that if I'm at a certain node, everything on the left half is smaller and everything on the right half is bigger. Again, I think it helps just in understanding and designing the data structure to remember that this is an important thing. And I need to make sure that all the methods and all the operations I do preserve this. And in that particular case, it allows me to search quickly. And without that invariant, I'd lose it. But at the same time, it lets you formally prove correctness. So it's a pretty good dual. I think it helps you reason about it informally and lets you formally, in fact, prove that you haven't forgotten any cases. So how do you know when you have the right answer? Certainly, it's good to prove you're always going to have the right answer. But that proof is about the technique that you create it, it doesn't say that your code is right. So I think you actually want to prove, or rather informally at least, that you're going to always have the right answer, but you need tests. Without unit tests, bugs will creep in. The book we wrote, we have a couple thousand unit tests. And I'll tell you, there's times in the end I'm like, oh, I can make this a little simpler. I didn't need this case. And all the unit tests start going red. And then I put a sentence about why you needed it. So I think you actually need testing in the code to make sure the code actually really implemented what you intended, and testing at the algorithmic level. So looking at the difference in dealing with sort of algorithmic complexity, making sure you actually cover all the cases of the input, and dealing with sort of complexity of the code and different operating systems, different windows. It's tricky, and also everyone wants to try out different things, and so you have all these little different variations, and the code gets a lot of cruft built into it that kind of can get it out of hand. And so I think in the industry code, it's also important to kind of keep that in check. What makes for good code? Clean, should be fairly modular. You don't want the two-page method. You definitely want to make sure that commonly used blocks are reused. And, some documentation in the methods, whether in a separate file, like if it's a C++ with an H file or something where it's all together, you definitely want to really say what the method's doing. In the end, good code is code that other people can come and change and adapt.